Hope this is the right track. It is.
Okay, here we go.
Summer drinking, endless rosé. How are these fuckers not all in AA? Pretty people with booming careers. Lover boy, enough to last 7 years. Hampton's clubs don't activate hubs. India, oh, the summer house. Oh, well, oh, well, oh, well.
Sing it with us. Tell me more, tell me more.
Will they take Hannah's calls? Can we see Carl's three balls? Shoo bop bop, 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 shoo bop bop.
I can't catch a break with this fucking wedding.
See,
oh no.
That's what I do. Right, woo-ho, man?
Hey, bad boy.
Hi. Look, I want to botch you. I'm going to come botch you. You just thought
you were going to have a wedding, and I said, no,
you're not. I'm going to come over there and botch you, and you're going to have a tough 2 weeks.
Hey, Brad, you want to botch his wife, too?
Ooh, yeah. That's a cute-looking hoodie over there.
Yeah.
Ooh, I done something bad.
Y'all, this is Summer House. Season 6, episode 15.
The bad and Miss Kova got him, y'all.
They got him. A happy ending. Boy.
Happy sending.
Happy sending.
What'd you write? Ending?
Yeah, I wrote ending. It probably
auto-corrected.
Yeah.
You need to take that off because that happens like
all the time.
All the time.
But I'm you. You're my autocorrect.
I am not your autocorrect.
But you are. It works out.
I'm going to stop correcting you.
That is something you cannot do.
You know
do.
What? You're right. I will say good luck ever doing this show without me because the misinformation that you will put out.
I want to do the show without you.
That is so
Why
sweet.
Why would I want to do that?
What if something
you?
Happens to me?
Well, I'll do a different show.
I'll haunt you.
No, I mean, I won't cover now. I don't think I'd cover 90 Day Fiance.
Oh, that is sweet. The same would happen for you. Yeah.
Sure. Sure.
I could hire a country clown from a rodeo.
There you go. That's where I was born, right in the barrel.
This is Summer House. This is the finale. It looks like we're going to be treated to a two-part finale. No idea why we have so much information to cover.
Y'all can't see. I keep thinking this is an intimate portrait. We're rolling our eyes like you're watching us, but I'm rolling my eyes.
I think I live my life rolling my eyes.
You do? How many times did you roll your eyes at your mother?
Oh, I couldn't. If she ever saw me, she said, don't you roll your eyes at me. It was, but I had a problem as a child where I would just kind of look one way. When you learn how to roll your eyes as a child, I never stopped doing it. Teachers would comment on me. Even now, I have to be really careful that when someone says something that I think is ridiculous, I don't go,
I never did it because, and this, I'm not teasing you, I'm saying legitimately, I never did it because it's a thing like girls did. Like, at least where I was from, boys didn't roll their eyes.
So, I understand what you're saying, but it was
that way for you, or like, no?
No.
I'm genuinely asking.
No.
Sissies might be like, I've got a boy and he rolls his eyes at me all the fucking time.
I
think that's just my own weird
my
thinking.
I think I've never heard that, but maybe
I think
you're
it's
right.
My own weird thinking.
I don't
that's
know.
That's why I'm testing. Come at me. No.
I'm just saying, but all the Wonder Woman loving and makeup trying to wear and Haley Mills movies.
No, I'm not digging at you. I was saying, though, but when I grew up, though, I was like, no, girls, like, roll their eyes.
And that's what you draw your line at.
That's just where I was a kid. I was like, I'm not going to roll my eyes.
Not singing Whitney Houston.
No, not that. Not that.
Were there other things girls did that you didn't want to do? Just eye rolling.
I'll get back to you on that one. That's a good one.
That is nuts that that's the one you brought up.
That's I didn't know.
Short skirts, maybe.
Maybe. I never
that
really wanted
ridiculous.
To wear a skirt. Well, those cheerleading skirts with the flaps in them. I did enjoy those.
I think children who were kind of disruptor children rolled their eyes all the time, regardless of male or female.
Probably, yeah.
But that's interesting that you... I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong.
I wasn't really a disruptor. Well, I was a brat. I was high maintenance as a kid.
I think all children are. Maybe y'all have good children.
My nephews weren't. Both of my nephews were not high maintenance at all.
I don't know. What do you think high maintenance as a child was?
I just wanted attention a lot as a child.
Well, nothing's changed.
Thank you.
I didn't as much, but there were certain times I wanted it. But I was happy to not. I think that's maybe it's the being the younger child, because maybe. Your brother got everything and
well, you get to have fun and all the expectations on you. Don't fuck it up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's talk about that. Yeah. Not childhood trauma.
Yeah.
A happy sending.
A happy sending.
And I kept thinking. My favorite part about this episode. And this was one of my tea bags, is watching everyone in this cast say, you know, if I'm really happy, I think they could everyone just eat like really like tough crow meat.
That was one of
at
those
this ideas. Wedding.
None of them
like,
are.
Like Sierra's like, I mean, I guess if they can make it work, yeah. I'm like, I'm impressed.
Sierra was the best.
It was the most honest.
It was the most because she said all the best. And y'all, that none of them like these couple.
No.
And all of them know. Even Danielle's like in her head going, yeah, this isn't going to work out.
Well, I don't think any of us think that they are what I would consider endgame or let me be clear that they enrich each other instead of either bringing out the worst in one another and being able to solve that. It's like an endless cycle of bringing out the worst in one another, fighting, and then being okay with it. And
yeah.
But I don't know if they're going to ever find that way where they can really complement one another. I think they can maybe focus on each other's where the other lacks. And you know what? Maybe that's a successful relationship in 2022.
Maybe.
Who am I to critique?
Maybe.
But I just love it how the cast was just like, this beef jerky is really salty. When they were talking about, and it was, I think it was Paige, like, you know, they've surpassed expectations. I mean, it's going to be great. And I was thinking, wow. It was really entertaining watching these fuckers try to explain away this marriage.
I kind of was hoping Hannah would show up the last minute.
Me too.
God, that would have been good.
No, they did not want her there for a certain.
No.
Because Hannah has said nothing but negative things about them as a couple.
Nothing but negative things about them as a couple. As we all have that aren't on that show.
Yeah. I kind of respect that about Hannah. That she'll be.
I respect more things about Hannah now that she's gone.
Yeah.
Anyway, y'all, okay, we're going to jump into our tea bags real quick. First of all, y'all, I did this morning, and it's already up, I guessed it on the Rose Pricks podcast. It's normally with Stephanie. I've never met the other co-host, but Stephanie I met through Ronnie. So Stephanie Wilder-Taylor, and she normally talks about The Bachelor. But
Wilder or Wilder?
That's what I said, Wilder.
Wilder.
Yeah, Stephanie Wilder-Taylor, and... They talk about Bachelor.
Right.
But Bachelor's on hiatus. So she started watching 90 Day Fiance. And it's interesting listening to her takes of she's never really watched the show. This is the first time she's ever met Ari.
Oh.
All that. So anyway, we had a great conversation. The podcast is up. So I'll be sure to tweet it out and put it in the Facebook group and stuff. But be sure to check that out. Just wanted to say
that. Did she have thoughts on... You will get it done.
She did. And I can't wait. I'm going to bring this up on the 90 Day Show. She has completely turned my head about Jabri and Miona.
Really?
Completely turned my head, and particularly Jabri's mom. She's
How
completely
so?
Flipped me. I don't like his mother now.
Interesting.
I'll save it for the show. But okay. Oh, my God. Now, granted, Stephanie's mother was a therapist, so she might be bringing some of her own shit into it. But she admitted that. But still, I went, oh, my God, I see it.
I could see mom trying to torpedo it.
Yeah.
I'm fine with mom torpedoing it, what they have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But because anyway,
I don't think it's only real in both of their minds.
Exactly.
So anyway.
Anyway, what other announcements do we have? I'm going to turn on timing.
Live shows.
Live shows.
Don't stop screaming.
Live shows.
You know what? I just said stop screaming to you, and all of a sudden I was thrust back into time where I heard my mother say, "Jaybird, stop screaming."
My dad said it to me all the time. Matthew, would you stop fucking yelling across the goddamn house? All the time he'd say,
"Jaybird, my ears."
It's true. It's true.
And now I do that. Stop screaming.
It's true.
We do. So live shows, y'all. We've got our summer should be fun.
Summer should be fun.
Version of Live Laugh Live. We're going to 10 cities. You can check it out on our link tree on our Instagram. There are some listeners who, God bless these Carl's wives, who say, "I don't know. I went to the website and I can't find a link for a link tree," and it's on our Instagram. So
if you go to the website, it's just a big ass picture with big letters that says buy live show tickets.
So
click on that.
You can go to the website.
Same
now.
Thing. Yeah,
realitygaze.com. It's not for porn anymore.
It's not for porn anymore. Remember when it was?
That was an interesting time. So
I think that's it. No other announcements.
No.
We'll have some collabs that we're recording this week that we'll start announcing this month. So
we got pig royalty interviews coming up. We're very excited.
We're very.
Can we announce this? I'm a little scared to announce it because they
I
might
think
pull.
So
out.
We I think it's confirmed.
Okay, we have three rounds of interviews, maybe four.
Maybe four.
We're like fucking Barbara Walters with this show.
But
okay, yeah. we can confirm Teresa and Kim McCullough. Teresa Nugget's mom and Kim McCullough will be one batch of interviews. And I can't believe we're doing this, but Michelle Valera and Joy Pepper are going to be sitting down for an interview.
We talked on the phone to Michelle Valera today for like 20 minutes.
And she was lovely.
I was just about to say, and she was lovely. And said some already super interesting things. And we went, oh.
I leaned in and my mouth dropped open like Michelle Valera.
Very excited for this.
I mouth breathed for at least 10 seconds.
You know, because we're going to talk to some of them. We're going to talk to but we're not going to talk to Tyler because y'all told us.
No, and we'll be talking to, of course, Jody and the Reens.
So anyway, those will be coming out in the next week. And then the Reens are going to be, and I think the Tykes are going to be at our Austin show.
Yes.
So, all right. Okay. My first teabag, I'll jump in. So remember, y'all, the episode starting with Amanda and Kyle fighting.
Pernerp fighting. Everybody was Pernerp
which
fighting.
I still say is a fraudacity storyline.
Totally.
And guess what? 100%. We were right.
Yeah.
But Kyle walks up to her and he says, "I don't want to talk about this now." And I went, "You brought it up."
He did.
That's
he totally
all I
did.
Wanted to say. You brought it up.
And I like it how Amanda knows Kyle enough to when he's going for, like, especially if he's been drinking, if he's like saying an argument that's absolutely ridiculous, the only thing she's like, "I know, let's stop talking about it. I know, let's move on." And he still wants to fight. She's like, "Kyle, stop talking about it." And I mean, I guess she's going to be happy doing that the rest of her life.
I don't know. Sometimes I feel like when she talks to him, she needs to say, "Kyle, what did I just say?" And I don't think he could repeat it.
Well, I think that's part of the problem because she talks down to him like he's a child. And I think maybe that's what has to happen sometimes.
Maybe, even though she doesn't do a lot of things.
Right. I liked it that she just kind of walked out holding that balloon.
she was
the little prince or something.
And I'm going to say something, y'all.
Didn't like watching that balloon. I'll say that right now.
I'm going to say this. Hashtag protect poodle. I know y'all are seeing a lot of balloon popping videos.
Don't you, like them.
You can send them to me. You can post them.
I don't click
them
on them anymore.
You can post them in the Facebook group if you want. Don't send them to Poodle or a reality gaze.
You know what it is?
He doesn't want to click on that.
I don't mind the balloon when they're popping like crazy What I do, someone did send me a video of people being scared by balloon popping.
You don't like that.
I watched it for 3 seconds and had to stop.
I'm telling you, hashtag protect poodle. Send it to me. I'll laugh about it and I'll love it. Post it in the group. But don't send it to him or the reality gaze account. I'm going to protect
poodle. I don't
poodle.
Want any more balloon popping videos.
No.
I do. For those of you who only listen to Summer House, I have never liked balloons because I have a fear of them popping and it's scaring me.
Yeah.
I don't like loud noises, so it goes along with that. Yeah. I don't like the way the balloons feel, like all of it. Don't like balloons. And I know some of you out there are balloon makers and whatever.
No.
Good.
Well, it's called balloonophobia for a reason.
It's not called balloonophobia.
It is.
I'm sure there's a...
No,
there's
it's called balloonophobia.
It is not. I'm sure there's a Latin word or something. Like triskaidekaphobia, the fear of 13.
Maybe. What's your next teabag?
Mine is... I busted out laughing watching Sierra and Paige run up the stairs like the evil stepsisters to hear their argument.
They really did. And you know what? If Jake and
in
I were in that house,
gowns.
We would have done the same thing.
It felt very relatable.
Same thing. She would have pushed me out of the way to listen, and then I would have grabbed him.
That's basically what they did.
That's what we would have did. It was like out of a Disney cartoon.
It was. Because they're just so ready. Because what they were ready to do is they were ready for it to be a complete knockdown, drag out, and for them to do their job in the cycle of comforting Amanda and Amanda sobbing.
But it didn't happen this time.
It did not happen this time.
It did not happen.
It's going to be interesting once they get married. I think maybe they'll still be in Summer House. Who knows? But I think Amanda's going to think differently about her friends, her single girlfriends.
I think so.
I think she's going to try to get married friends. I just have this idea of what Amanda thinks being married is like.
Maybe. I think so, too. I mean, maybe Carl and Lindsay will be married if it's real.
I still don't know. I want to.
We should talk about. We talked about this on another show. We didn't talk about it, I don't think, on Summer House. Actually, did we talk about what Craig said on the? I don't think we talked about it.
Craig
on
and
Summer
Austin House. On there, and the thing is, I don't know how reliable either of them are.
This is Craig.
Yeah, how blasted he was.
Yeah,
but Craig said that it's all fake.
He said anybody that believe. Basically, he said. Lindsay is made to look like a princess, and the show is edited to favor her.
Yeah,
he completely.
What's his reasoning behind that?
I don't
that?
Know. He said the. Yeah. He said I'd have to listen to it. I don't know if they post their live shows. He said, "I would do a live show with Craig and Austin," but he said that
I kind of would too.
He said that they're. He said that the crews for Winter House and Summer House are horrible.
Wow.
Even though he's going to be on, I think he's on the next
what
season of Winter.
What is he doing?
Literally, as I said before, Craig always bites the hand that feeds him.
You can't criticize the crew.
And so he said they're horrible, that Lindsay's always edited to look good, even though all the messy shit he said, if they'd seen all the messy shit she did, he said no, everybody would have a totally different opinion about her.
You mean if we had seen it or the crew? Okay.
And then he said, and anyone that believes that Lindsay and Carl are together are kidding themselves.
Wow. It's I
and
guess,
Austin verified, like, of course, Austin also said he got a bad edit on Summer House and that's why he looked like a douche. Don't think that's the reason.
He did get a bad edit because he did everything.
That would be Austin saying, like, I didn't mean to say that. My tongue got in the way.
I mean, what are you talking about,
boys? What are you talking about? Anyway, that's the tea.
But what I would push him for is to say, why do you think Lindsay gets a good edit when I don't think Kyle gets a good edit at all? And he is he's also in the same position that Lindsay is.
I don't know. Well, for instance, I think she does, not necessarily good at it, but like, this is my tea bag, but I'm bringing it up because it's with, you know, when Lindsay says, well, it looks like it's between two idiots. And she says, Carl or Austin. And then I went.
No, did she say Austin? I thought she said something like Robert's best friend. Maybe no, I heard wrong.
I heard Austin.
Maybe. Oh, you're right.
And it was on closed caption when I watched it.
Then
you're
right.
But when she said that, I went, wait a minute. But I thought you don't have feelings for it. Like, it's so...
That's garbage.
So anyway, that's... So going along with that, it's like they didn't really show a lot of that.
But I'm just... I just want to press this. What would be... What would be the end game?
This is like a... Trying to figure out what Craig's thinking of. Because Craig always... I mean, here's the deal with Craig. He does this on Summer House. He bitches and moans about things. But he's usually right.
I understand what you're saying.
There's usually like a truth to it.
What I'm hearing though is why would you have her around for? I would also because Carl used to not get a good edit at all.
Yeah.
Then he got sober and he started getting better edits.
Mm-hmm.
And
he had a good edit last season.
Yeah. But it's kind of like to what end? I would ask if the show is trying to make Lindsay end up with Carl. Then you saying she's been getting a good edit since she's gotten the crazy, and I'm using that word choice because that's what they've called Lindsay, activated. She's always gotten that kind of like wild card.
I agree with you. I'm just saying that Craig is saying we didn't see.
Yeah.
But Craig uses that a lot, vagueness of you don't know what was behind.
But I think it's a fair thing to ask what that is true, and I could actually see it being true this season, to what end?
If you're going
to
vague book it, tell us the details. Yeah.
Right. I guess, I don't know. I guess I would saying, so what if she, what would the show be trying to do with that?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe you and Craig need to have a private conversation. Look in his eyes.
He is... Y'all, I know some people don't think he's attractive at all. I think he's just so cute.
He's very cute. What's your
anyway? Where was I? Did you do one?
Yeah, I've done two.
Oh, that is my turn.
You can do two in a row because I did two in a row.
Number four, Danielle's going to Charleston.
Oh,
to Charleston.
So this is one of my team, but I'm asking. Is Danielle, are they going to be on Southern Charm?
I don't know. She says she's going to be going back to New York a lot. I don't know if Robert has enough charisma to be on a reality show.
Oh, I'm going to say no. Going to say no. Computer says no.
She could still do Summer House in the summer. I mean...
Because they usually do Southern... Well, who knows? But they often, when it comes out of the summer, they
maybe she'll be
spring.
A guest... But yeah, there's no way she's going to be a main.
I bet Paige will be on Southern Charm because she's with Craig.
I think Paige and Craig both are thinking about their options.
I think Patricia Altschul is going to love Paige.
Oh yeah. It's interesting. There's talk in the Bravo world that a lot of the Bravo world do not like Paige and Craig together.
Really?
Yeah. So
I wonder why.
Because they tried to one of the reasons behind the Craig Paige / Lindsay Carl drama is that supposedly I only know this from reading some Bravo gossip that Craig and Paige thought they were going to become the it couple. But they chose to make this season about Lindsay and Carl getting together. And because Craig and Paige, it's been touch and go. And they've been like kind of hot and cold and hot
and cold. I
will say they're
way more interesting. Carl, when they had this conversation,
agree.
Carl and Lindsay were kind of boring.
No, I agree. And that's why I still doubt it, honestly. It doesn't. To be honest, and I have no reason to do this, but it doesn't feel real to me. But I say good for them if they're finding a way to make a friendship turn into that.
If it happens for real, it's 100%, I think, because Lindsay realizes this person's going to be a good father and I want to have kids.
Yeah, I agree.
And he seems nice enough.
And what would it be for him?
He actually has feelings for her, I would think.
Interesting.
Or he wants to make a safe bet because he knows she's
hedging it.
He doesn't have to apologize to her for his past. He doesn't have to reveal that to someone. They've already seen. There's something.
She accepts him for who he is.
There's something comforting about knowing you're in a better place now and someone saw you in a shitty place and they still love you and are with you as a friend.
That's fair.
That's like something you.
And I would push back and say, what's wrong with that?
No.
If they're happy about that.
I mean, that's not your way. I mean, you ghost them and then you change your phone number.
And then I beg for them to take me back 2 years later when I see them at a bar and I'm drunk.
Or you don't remember their name.
That's part of it.
I remember together. What's your name again?
What's your name again? Can
we say it again? I mean, wait. Where'd you live again? Were you at that place in Echo Park? Oh, no. Never mind. I'm going to talk to you later.
Then I leave.
Who is that guy? Who was the one I was talking about?
Y'all, Poodle has. It is funny that.
That's based on a real experience.
I don't remember anyone on these shows. Poodle doesn't remember a lot of people he's dated.
I don't.
Because we have left bars and you were like, wait, what was his name again? I'm like, you dated him.
There's too many. And they all look the same. Gay guys do.
They do.
It's really bad. What's your next teabag?
You realize you just said all gay guys look the same.
They do.
You're welcome, America. You're welcome.
They all talk the same. We all look the same. We all talk the same.
I just would say, Alex.
It's shameful.
It's shameful. Alex, Sierra's not going to tell you who's the best kisser because we saw.
Because we know it's not you.
It's fucking Carl. We saw that kiss and it was made me moist in the middle.
Men.
I mean, like a Duncan Hines cake.
If you're asking who's the better kisser and they won't tell you, you ain't it.
You ain't it.
Come on.
Because guess what? If you're the best kisser, you don't have to ask.
Exactly.
They let you know.
That's like, I've never had to ask
no.
if I'm good or not.
Yeah.
I take it as the when the flag is raising, that's how I know.
Wow. I was trying to do a somber harmony.
Didn't love it.
Thank you.
But that's okay.
Thank you.
You don't have to thank me for a criticism.
You're welcome.
So, anyway, what's your next one? I've done mine.
My next one is a commercial break, and we're going to take it, and we'll be right back.
We're back.
Okay, so my next teabag is when Paige is like, I can't believe you were in New Jersey.
I know.
And you surprised me. And Craig's like, yeah, he said, I know. And she's like, it's so sweet. And then he's like, this Uber driver. And he tells her all about the Uber driver. And Paige goes, that's the sweetest thing I've ever heard. And the funny thing is, y'all, is we actually have that audio of Craig in his Uber driver's car. We're going to play exclusively.
For some reason, the Uber driver was recording it.
Yes.
I don't know.
Well, they record everything for safety.
Maybe
now.
For taxicab Uber confessions.
Yes, maybe. Anyway, turns out his cousin fucked Poodle, and we were able to. Yeah, it's true.
It pays to be connected.
It's true. It's mm-hmm. when Poodle spent a weekend 10 years ago in the Hamptons.
Oof.
And so now we've gotten that audio. The audio we've gotten
such a reach. It's amazing.
And a reach around.
I know. Reaching for my reach arounds.
There you go.
You did that and it didn't make a sound.
It did?
No, because it was timed quiet.
Reaching for my reach. That's the name of your 10th autobiography.
Reaching for the reach around. There it goes.
There we go. All right, everybody. And action.
Hey, bro. Where do you want to go? Bro.
That voice.
Hello.
Hey, where are you going?
Use the Uber for Craig.
Yeah, that's what it says here.
Okay,
Craig.
Okay, I'm going to Hamptons.
Where are you going, bro?
Hi, my name's Craig.
Oh, my God. I want to go to that club.
What club?
I always wanted to go to that Hampton Social Club. Bro, let's go there.
Yeah, oh, my God. It's so fun. Like, they have Red Bull and vodka
for
$1.
I love Red Bull and vodka.
Oh, my God. I love you. You are so. What's your name, dude?
Abdul.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice
to meet you. We should totally go out. Like,
Yeah, I don't go out with gay guys, but that's fine.
I just meant it's like, you know, like we could go, hey, and Grass, did you like pillows? I'd like to give you some pillows for your car.
Can we not talk?
Okay. Well, I'm going. Wow, look at your arms. They're so hairy.
I know.
I'm not hairy.
Like, I can tell.
Oh, you should see my asshole. It is
You have
so,
an asshole like a woman?
It is so smooth. Hmm. That's like, it's
kinda,
like you're.
That's kind of hot. I'd be okay with a smooth asshole if it was on you.
It's like your wife's asshole, but then you like wax it.
I don't know. I think my wife's asshole is not as good as yours.
Thank you. Very much. I'm gonna, speaking of why, I'm going to go meet my girlfriend.
Oh, you got a girlfriend? That's a surprise.
Yeah. I'm going to meet my girlfriend. She's so.
You sure you're not gay?
I love her.
Okay.
It's gonna be great.
You know, all the best to you. We're coming up there soon.
Okay. All right, I'm here.
Bye, bro.
If you want some pillows, are you gonna wish me luck or anything, you know?
I got it my next fare. So,
okay.
Yeah. Have fun.
And sing. A little different than what Craig said.
He was very interested in Craig's.
Very interested in Craig's.
Girlfriend. Which he was shocked by.
Didn't expect that voice.
Bro. That's every Uber driver I've calls me bro.
Yeah, they do all call me bro. Mm-hmm. Bro.
Yeah.
It's true.
So, it doesn't matter who they are,
I've had a couple of gay Uber drivers, but you hear how, like, I have friends that I know that have fucked their Uber or Lyft driver.
I still can't imagine. No.
I never, well, first of all, I'm with some, but I would never broach that.
You have
two people that fucked their shared Uber driver
person.
How
did it happen?
One just said they just started talking, and then he asked for his number, and then.
Oh, so it wasn't at the end of the
He asked for
ride.
His number at the end of the day, and then he said, you know what? And he turned the fare off, and they went and fucked in the car.
In the car? See, that's just unprofessional.
What
if I had to get in there next?
But they already had those seat covers that keep all the stains away, probably.
True.
And it smelled like that cherry.
I just don't imagine. How do you cross that Rubicon?
I don't know. And also, I'm not a parent. Sometimes parents have to do it where they can. But I will say, and I don't like to admit this, I'm too old to fuck in a car.
Yeah.
Do you know how stiff my neck would be if I fucked in a car now?
So you're saying it'd be okay if you were a parent because you don't have a chance to do
a lot of things? Because parents, like, sometimes they, like, their kids are in the house. Violet, Jimmy, y'all go play with your Legos and Daddy and Mommy are going to go do yard work and you bang in the Toyota Tacoma.
I see.
Yeah. You got to do it somewhere.
Okay. So you leave your kids unsupervised.
They're
and you
old
go
enough.
Playing.
They're not going to swallow the Legos. They'll build something.
Okay.
You know what? Parents are doing the best they can.
I get it. I think I would be, at least on an app.
But I don't know how. Yeah.
There's a mutual interest going in. When you're with an Uber driver, that is someone who's performing.
I worry about sexual harassment.
Yes.
That's what I worry about, too.
Just to change what's happening, the service being performed is quite different.
Y'all, have you fucked your Lyft driver? Come at us. Let us know.
And then it seems like at the end, you'd have to tip them more.
And honestly, yes.
I know.
It's like when I got a massage once and he gave me a handy that I did not want. I had to give him $20 more.
Yeah. Sounds like you didn't fight it.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
I'm not a prude, but I just could not do that if someone just started touching me.
I didn't know what to do.
You say, not that.
Then
it's
that would
very
be rude.
Easy.
He would have felt bad.
Yeah, I don't think I'm thinking about the other person's feelings.
That's too, I was too Southern, agreed.
Even though it was last year. Yeah.
No, it was years ago. But I should have known the friend who recommended me to go there is a slut. He still is.
Wow.
Good for him. Anyway,
we're in a weird area.
Also, I just want to say, if I was the person employed by Uber or Lyft, I could never sleep with someone because I would worry about getting sued.
Yeah, I think.
Are we too in our heads? Are we not free enough?
I would just be worried about someone, what if the person I slept with, what if he told Uber?
You lose your job.
I feel like that's literally shitting where you eat.
Yeah.
Or fucking where you eat.
Fucking where you eat. What's your next tea bag?
You told me that story about having two friends. I have slutty friends too. I've never had friends who've done that.
I have one. Remember I told you the friend who like he spoke, my friends could speak Spanish,
yes.
And he went to Home Depot.
That I kind
and,
of,
like, got a day
that
worker.
That I kind of buy.
He got him, the day worker helped him move, and at the end, the day worker said, are you not giving him any dick? And he pulled out his dick, and he fucked the day worker, and they had sex.
Yeah,
and I'm like,
all of this is blurring the lines of sex work.
I can't do that.
And I think it's okay if you want to do sex work.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe just put it out there first.
If we're going to fuck and I'm paying you or vice versa, I want it in writing.
I just feel like we're crossing boundaries that aren't normally commerce boundaries.
Are we prudes?
I'd hope not.
Y'all
come at us. Are we prudes?
I don't know.
Do people fuck their Uber drivers more often than we don't know?
Maybe.
I don't know. Like I said, I'm not going to shame anyone. When you told me that, I was kind of like, wow. Anyway.
And we're slutty.
I don't think I've had gay Uber drivers, but I've never wanted to bone any of them.
It'd be like if you work somewhere and you brought someone to your office and fucked them there. Like, who would do that? Who would do that? It's so unprofessional.
Very different. There wasn't a lot of space around there.
Who would fuck them on their boss's desk?
And I wasn't paying them. I might as well have given them something. What's my next one? Paige later on calls Craig because she's trying to tell, it's the wedding day, and she's trying to tell, they're trying to crib notes from someone's wedding vows. So I guess it's okay. Y'all write your own wedding vows.
And
don't repeat something you heard.
Okay, so I go back and forth on this. A part of me says, is it bad that a part of me thought you're doing your wedding vows on the day of the wedding?
That's super common. People do that more than you think.
Do a lot of people do that because it's like you want to be in the moment of that day?
No, I don't think you've put it off, and then you say, oh my God, I got to write my wedding vows.
I mean, I haven't gotten married yet, so I'll see.
But I think that's more common than you'd think. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I had that thought too. And I there's a friend I always text with who's married, and they're like, totally did that.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I wasn't coming to judge. I was just like, I wondered. So there we go.
No, it's a more common than you'd think.
Wow.
Because I think it's like the last thing you forget to do.
Yeah. And they had so much to do because they got COVID.
Because they got COVID. The bad end is COVID got them. Ooh, hey, boy. Anyhow.
So that's y'all. There's not
What's
much.
That quote about the wedding day?
They got COVID. They're home for a week. They can't plan any of these things. So they had to just sit and be with each other.
And it's basically cell phone video of people crying.
It is. And they act like, yes, I'm sure it was a lot, but
just
they
blowing
act like
noses.
They act as if they literally climbed a mountain together while deathly sick with COVID. And I want to just, and then when they came on the other, they're like, we came through the other side. And I'm like,
this is storytelling to pull a rabbit out of the hat because we've been shitting on Kyle and Amanda for
the
relationship.
Season.
3 years.
Yeah.
Or even, we've been calling out their relationship for 4 years now, because they got together in season 3, I believe. Yeah. And, but it's like, and so now Bravo is going to make everything okay, and it's just not possible.
It's just not possible. Yeah. And I was just like, y'all, whatever. What went through so much.
What's your next one? Or maybe it's my turn.
It's your turn.
We talked about the friends trying to eat crow. Amanda, part of her vows, she's like, I didn't know love at first sight was real till I saw you on Instagram.
And on
Instagram. Like, this is perfect. This is so summer house, Gen Z, Amanda. It's just perfect.
It is perfect. She also said, I promise to love you and kiss you every night before bed. And I went, Gary, can you roll that tape of how many nights have we seen Kyle go
to bed?
Kyle on the bed going, yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
I guess. And she'd be like, no, no, I hate you.
Granted, he did do something really awful probably about an hour before, but that's how they talk to one another.
But I
thought, it's very normal.
Good luck with that, Val. Hope you don't break that one.
And then there's the cribbed one where she's like, I promise to do everything. I promise to take interest in the little things you love that make you happy. And I think for me, this is because I'm an Enneagram 4, totally. But like, I would never steal what I knew was someone else's part of someone else's vows.
I'm not an Enneagram 4, and I wouldn't do that.
Yeah.
I think it's just I want something to come from my heart,
yeah,
not from something I read online.
I was just like, what does that tell you?
Now, if I feel stuck, I might like read other things
or
for
Google.
Inspiration, but not just plagiarism.
I know.
Not thou plagiarism.
I would rather you say, I'm just going to read something. I'm going to read Rudyard Kipling's If, you know, or something like that. That
to
me. I
write that all the time.
Why?
Oh, when you get in trouble in Miss Seifert's class in eighth grade, you'd have to write If.
Stop! Yep. She made you write it over
and over.
She
made write the whole poem.
Oh, my God.
Jared Bates had it memorized. He could write
Do
it
you
in
remember
2 minutes.
It?
Don't even remember a word.
What? So it obviously was helpful.
I didn't have to write as much. I didn't get in trouble a lot. I probably had to write it like 4 times.
She made you write the Rudyard Kipling poem, If.
Yes.
Because she thought that would seep into you somehow, that you'll one day actually become a man, my son. She was wrong.
Because she made the girls do it too.
Interesting.
I guess the times
she
I got in trouble
it
for
you, you'll become a woman. Daughter,
my daughter. That from talking too much in class. That's why I got in trouble.
So
was I talk.
You would learn because you were writing Rudyard Kipling's If over and over and over again.
Yeah,
because
you had to write it like 10 times. It wasn't a short poem.
It's not.
It's not. You had to write it all like 10 times.
We need to move on because I'm never going to understand this.
She loved diagramming too. She was really pretty. I look back at it. She was a pretty horrible person. Really wasn't very happy at all. And then died of like pancreatic cancer and told no one.
She
told no one. The only people that went were Superintendent Gary Don Scott and
Gary Don Scott.
Mr. Scott. Yeah, Gary Don Scott. The
Gary Don.
But, I mean, his name was Gary Scott. But, yeah, it was Gary Don Scott.
We have to move on.
Anyway.
Please. I have so many follow-up questions, but they are for a different time.
Okay.
What's your next one?
I just want to say again, I'm not moved by this at all. I'm not moved by the vows. Were you touched at all? I was not.
You know, the only part that I was kind of, I thought it was all pretty. I think both of them feel pretty authentically or think they do. There was one spot where she tapped him on the shoulder and he saw her for the first time and his mouth quivered. And they love one another or what they think.
They do.
They love one another. That's honest. And so I honestly, if I can keep myself in the present and say these are two people who are in love and they love one another.
They love love.
It's they love love love. It is moving, and that part did do something for me.
Okay.
I thought it was more funny than anything else.
But that part was like if any part moved me, it was that.
What'd you think of her dress?
I thought it was appropriate for the venue.
I did too.
I didn't love the dress, but I thought it was appropriate for the venue.
I wanted something a little. She looked gorgeous
in it.
It was really nice fitted.
It was very Caroline Kennedy.
It was. I just didn't think it was her.
I agree with that.
There was not a lot of Amanda's style in it.
It looked like she was trying to play a bride.
Yes.
I loved his tux, though. I loved the blue, especially for an outdoor wedding. It's a little more cat. Loved it.
Yeah, he looked good. It fit well.
Carl looked good, too.
Now, I got to also apologize. When he was walking down there, I was like, she's thick. And you had said that. And you're right. She is very thick in her legs.
Ooh, he just, I'd stand in front of me in that tux and just pulled out that thick dick.
Wow.
Go to town. Yeah.
Changing the wedding into something different.
I got a vow to get into that. What's your next one, Pooh?
I was going to talk about, I liked the dress she changed into much better.
Her reception dress.
It was kind of like cut down. Mm-hmm. I guess I just wanted, it looked like a dress you could buy anywhere. Even though I thought it was beautiful.
Yeah, it did look like a very nice David's bridal dress.
I wanted something a little more for her. Because she does have an interesting sense of style.
And her makeup was flawless.
Yeah, she looked great.
The makeup of the hair was fantastic.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Oh, yeah, and they got a floral designer. Woo!
At the very last minute. Her bouquet was pretty.
It was gorgeous.
I don't know. I don't have anything else to say. There's that scene at the end that you were talking about before with Lindsay and Carl talking. She's like, what if I have my feelings towards you? I don't know. And he's like, well, I don't know. And she's like, okay.
Okay.
And it kind of just ends.
I just want to say that, you know, when Lindsay's at a wedding, when she walks into the bar and says, can I have a Red Bull, please? Who serves Red Bull at their wedding? Who serves Red Bull at their wedding? I am asking.
I actually took that as a sign that she wasn't maybe drinking.
Okay, but I'm not serving Red Bull at my wedding.
No, I agree. It's trashy.
I am not.
I think full bars, though, they have Red Bull. So it's
I'm going to tell them no at my wedding because I don't want to smell it. The smell of it makes me sick.
Well, I think a lot of people use it as a mixer, so it's going to be there. I know, but those are your feelings. I'm saying if you go to a bar is always going to have Red Bull. It's just the nature of it. I know.
Did y'all have Red Bull at your wedding?
Sorry.
I need to know.
People who are our age and younger, they still drink Red Bull. You know that, right? People still drink
it. I'm not happy about it.
I don't. I'm not a fan, but.
I have one more tea bag. I don't know if I don't think you know about this. It's an episode, or it's part of the episode that y'all would have missed. It was a blink and you miss it. It was in the middle of the episode before even the wedding night when they're all going to bed and the night before. And we see that y'all remember Luke dating this girl named Nicole that we don't give a two fucks about.
Who I call irrelevant.
Irrelevant. But she's laying in the bed and
He's playing guitar.
And she says, play guitar, Luke. And I went, I think Luke finally found the perfect woman. But what y'all don't know is that there's an extended cut of Luke actually sang a song. And Poodle heard it.
I've got it written down.
He wrote it down. So today for you, we're going to end this episode and sing Luke's Summer House song. And
this has been this season of Summer House. We're all good looking people in a house. We all like the night air. Like to build a fire here in Summer House. Good looking people look better by firelight. Cause everybody likes some maple syrup. And you get out and you're gonna play in the snow. So get ready for Winter House coming soon. Promise this is not a commercial for Winter House. Or maybe though it kinda is. I'm a cowboy out on the road. Broom. I want a dog. Broom.
Y'all, that's the show. We'll see you at the tell-all.
So stupid.
And the slow part at the end. In September, they'll all go back to their Google Hangout, their Zoom, and their Slack.
And even though summer came to an end, they'll continue to be best of friends
on Insta.
Summer's nuts because of these sluts.
Oh.
But,
what are you gonna do?
That summer.